Hi, this is Leonor with LDM Creations, and today I'm going to be making some mass-produced Halloween cards. I've been missing in action for a while. I've been sick, and we were on vacation. But let me go ahead and show you what I'm going to be making. These are mass-produced cards, and I got the idea from a lady in YouTube, and I think her name is Catherine Stamps. I think it's KatherineSpooler.com is her website. So in any event, this is what I'm going to be making. It's this little Halloween cards, and they are A1 size. The cards are very easy to make. I have a lot of Halloween leftover items from last year. And I got this paper on sale last year. And it's called Spooktacular by Kane Company. It has a lot of cute Halloween patterns, and what I'm going to use is the little ghost. So the first step is to do an A2 card, and I'm going to cut it the long way. So I'm going to go ahead and use my score board to cut. I know you're not supposed to, but this is really easy for me, and the cuts come out straight. So I'm going to go ahead and cut it in half, and that's going to be at 4 1/4. So I'm going to go ahead and use my craft knife and cut it in half. And then it's really simple. I'm going to go ahead and score the card in half at 5 1/2 so I can form the A2 card the long way. So now that I have it, it's really easy. Let me go ahead and do the second one. And fold it. So now I have my base card. And I use these Halloween stamps from Inca Doodle. And I'm using the Happy Halloween stamp. And this is what they look like. I bought this on clearance last year, and I think they're really cute, so I'm going to be using these ones. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just stamp the Happy Halloween on the top. I'm going to get rid of my card, I'm sorry, of my scoreboard, so I can stamp. I have the A La Mode Blank Ink, and it's the pigment ink pad. So I'm going to go ahead and ink it up and stamp on my base card. I'm going to stamp the sentiment on the upper right-hand side. But you can stamp it on the left-hand side or the center if you wish. I'm just going to do them on the left, I'm sorry, on the right-hand side. Sorry. I'm still getting over being sick, so that's why I've been missing in action for a while. I was pretty sick last week. I went ahead and cut my 12 by 12 into 4 by 4 squares. And I used my Martha Stewart punch to do the little ribbon here. And basically, I punched the whole 12 by 12 card and punched the spider webs and then cut the strips at 1 inch, and then I measure 4 inches across. And what I'm gonna do next is put some adhesive on the little spider web border. Oh, I run out of glue, so let me go ahead and use my glue gun. And you're going to go ahead and adhere the little spider ribbon into the pattern paper. And I leave about maybe halfway of the strip showing. So you're going to see the spider web showing, and adhere them together. So the next step is to put the two pieces together into the card, and my glue gun is not, I'm sorry, my ATG is not cooperating, but I go ahead and line up the paper at the bottom of the card, and then I center it. So the card is 4 1/4, and this is 4 inches wide. So I go ahead and center it, and that's pretty much it. You know, the card is gets them pretty simple once you have all of the pieces done. So it's not a big deal. And I think I'm gonna continue doing this. And I'm gonna use probably other patterns on this pad because they have really cute patterns. And I have a lot of them to do. I have 35 of them to do. So I'm just gonna keep them really simple because they're for kids and you know they just throw things away, right? All they care about is candy. So I'm just gonna keep them really simple and type these and do Happy Halloween in every one of them. So I am pretty much done and I would like to thank you for stopping by and watching me. If you have any suggestions, please leave me a comment. And until the next time, thank you for watching and happy crafting.